hinges creak in doorless chambers, and strange and frightening sounds echo through the halls whenever candlelights flicker, where the air is deathly still. That is the time when ghosts are present, practicing their terror with ghoulish delight.
Muted.
Welcome, foolish mortals, to Luigi's Mansion. I am your ghost host, SM Bearcat, and before you say anything, yes, I'm re-uploading this. And I'm going to take the entire intro of this game to explain why. So I'm going to just go in here and erase the original file. And we get started. So, reason why I'm re-uploading this Let's Play is because, first off, it was not in 1080p high def, which this will be, and so will the videos to come. Second, there were a lot of lags in the in-game video and audio, which I think is because of the hard drive of my computer. My hard drive is not exactly that great on my computer, sadly. And in March, I had an entire little escapade of failures on my computer, and I got three parts on my computer replaced. I got the fan, hard drive, and disk drive replaced. So I'm hoping, because of the new hard drive and it's faster, that it'll be better to withstand my recording and hopefully won't have so many lags. That is at least my idea. Hopefully this works. And one of the other things about this Let's Play is it will be a very experimental. I'm going to be trying some new effects just to work with Pinnacle. And also, I'm going to see some whether or not I can make it look really cool. And this door is not letting us open. That's mean. Anyway, also, if you notice at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, you'll see a little watermark for a website called GameAnyone.com. So, about that watermark, I joined onto GameAnyone.com a couple of weeks ago. GameAnyone.com, for those of you who do not know, is a website that showcases all these video game walkthroughs, from Ocarina of Time to Mortal Kombat to Street Fighter to Portal. All those games, you can find walkthroughs on GameAnyone.com. And in order to be a director, you have to get at least 50 videos with this watermark on it, either visually, which is what you see at the bottom right-hand corner of the screen, or visual, or audio, or by a commentary saying, this is brought to you by GameAnyone.com. And since I'm constantly going to forget to say that it's brought to you by GameAnyone.com, I'm just going to use the watermark because it's a little bit easier and stuff like that. If you look on my GameAnyone.com account at the moment, there's nothing on it because they won't allow me to upload anything, and it won't actually go on the site until it is completely done. So once Luigi's Mansion is complete, then it'll go on the site. And it's also in 720 and they can't have any video lag either, so hopefully it is a good thing. So keep that posted. Every single time I do a brand new Let's Play, I'm gonna also be incorporating some new stuff. Mario Galaxy 2 will return, hopefully very soon. Super Paper Mario, however, is going to kind of just go somewhere. It will just stay away for a little while. I'm planning on doing that as a GameAnyone.com exclusive later, once I actually get the director status on there. So, once I get that, I will announce it on YouTube and I'll explain some other stuff. Anyway, I've been totally anti-reading these dialogue and scenes. So, we find this mansion, we find that there are all these crazy ghosts, and stuff like that, and we're running away. Okay. And now there's old guy. So your name's Luigi, I think our paths are destined to cross. Well met, Luigi. Where is this, you ask? Why, these cozy quarters are where I do my ghost studying. Professor Egad's Ghost Literature Laboratory. Otherwise known as the lab, if you were a shortening mind. Yeah, thanks. You want this mansion in a contest you didn't even enter? Sounds pretty fishy to me. You think? So you believe the mansion actually exists, then? Strange. I've been living here since I was a lot of 20 or so, and I tell you that mansion just appeared. Spirits, I fooled you. I knew it. It's an inception. I don't know if it's a dream or illusion or what all, but I sure wouldn't be happy winning a haunted house. Yeah, I wouldn't either by that. You just recalled, a guy with a red hat like yours went up to the mansion without even stopping in the chat, and he never returned. Ooh, yay, we have to save Mario. Plot twist. So, Weezin teaches to deal with ghosts. Cool. And then we have the screen that has all the controlling settings. Now, you can choose standard or sidestep. This pretty much says the control ship will move him from side to side. I just like using the standard one because I'm a standard person. And it's called the Poltergust 3000. Wow, that's original. Can suck up all kinds of things. That sounds weird. But alright. So, basically, the control, you use the R button to go around. Not the R button, the control stick. And the C stick to change direction. And I didn't even touch it. In conventional means, they use this as the only way to foil them. So, the light darkness and avoids the light. Here's what exactly what's going to happen. It's going to kind of like fishing. The B button in this game is your flashlight. And you see, ghost, you surprise it, and you don't hit that, you hit the wrong button. Derp. Attacking him up. Yeah, that's a great omen for this let's play. Anyway, take two. You hit it, then you press the R button back, and then you pull the control sticks back. Kind of like fishing, you're just kind of reeling the ghost in. Who just said this? Yeah, another thing to note about this let's play is I am kind of doing this blind. I have not touched this game since I originally got it, or since the original recording. There we go. So, since the second game, second episode of, oh crap, that's a lot of ghosts. See if I can get them all. Can I get them all? Oh, I only got one. Lame. Yeah, I've been doing this blind. I haven't done it for a while, so I've only done, like, the first area, so this should be a very interesting place. And I got 5 ghosts. It was a fail. Getting the hang of it, yeah, sure. Cool down at the gallery! You know what? Let's not do that. I will actually show the gallery in a later video to explain it once we actually get some of the gallery ghosts. And we'll explain that a little bit long. So let's go to the mansion! It's so scary. Oh, hey, and it's Toad here. Let's talk to him. Whoa, where'd you go, Mario? Wow. Oh, Luigi. Oh, wow, it's Luigi. Finally made an Ojoy block. He's asking to come here to look for Mario. He left when he heard you won a mansion, and he never returned. Then when I arrived here, the mansion was full of ghosts, and I didn't see Mario anywhere, and I kind of freaked out in a little, and I don't know what to do with the half-o. You have to help me find Mario. You have no idea how sick the princess will be. She'll flip. What do we have a feeling that I have, like, a vision right now of a psychopathic princess? Okay, we'll help, whatever. You may have a darkest turn that. That's interesting. You can do something. Wait, I got it. At least let me do this. And toads will be your save points in the game. It's very interesting how they did this. It's kind of nice, though. There are a couple of toads that are really easy to access. This one here, and then there's one actually we'll get a little later in the video. You can even help anytime. Well, let's go back into that room where we were before. So one of the things I'm also gonna try to do with this let's play is I'm also gonna try to get ending A, which entitles getting as much money as I possibly can, even though I know instinctively it's harder to do a poor man's run, which is try to get nothing. And because I know it's really hard, and because I'm an idiot, I'm not gonna do that. See if I can try to get all the money before I have to tackle the ghost, because it's going to be really a pain in the ass to do it otherwise. Oh, come on, I thought there was a gold bar up here. Damn it. Every other time I play, there's a gold bar up there. There we go. Alright, nah, I think I'm ready. And then we get this thing with the ghosts. And I don't really feel like saying this, because I've already done it before. Dark rooms are dangerous around here. Wow, you think? It's a haunted house. And they will get us. Ooh, wow. Big shock. And now we're in for it. Oh my god. Big deal. We can handle this. We got a vacuum. You can't handle us! I wonder, lost in the darkness. Sure. I ain't afraid. I ain't afraid of no ghosts, bitch. All right, let's kill their ass and be better than the training session. Yay, I don't suck. Ah! Lame. Die! I'm going in a circle. Ah! Ghost fun! Die! Yay! And I found a chest. Let's look. Mario. And... well, that was weird. It was just like messing the fucking the chest. And we got a key! Oh, hold on. This is Game Boy Horror. It's a complete mock-up of all the other... of the entire... dang. Hold on. Okay, sorry. Just trying to make sure that my game isn't glitching on me. Because sometimes there are a lot of lags and it can be a pain in the ass. Sorry about that. And we're opening a door! And... we enter the door! Oh, it's locked! That's great. Damn! I hear you! Yay! Ooh. Mine! Oh crap. Yeah! Two for the price of one, Grandma! Okay, that was rough. That just sounded weird. Ooh, and you are... okay, so now you see the mushroom. I get to talk about that. The mushrooms in this game actually work against you. They will shrink you, you'll drop some money, and you can't suck anybody else in for a certain amount of time. It is extremely, extremely annoying. I hate the mushrooms. And so, as Proton John would say, don't eat the mushroom! It's bad for you. Especially in this game. And anyone who knows exactly what I'm talking about with that reference, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. Because I actually played the Knit Story version of Don't Eat the Mushroom, and it is completely chippy. Are you not giving me anything? Okay, fine, screw you. Okay, I feel like I'm gonna attack one ghost here first. Before I... now that I have that done, I'm gonna go open this thing up, and... and kill this ghost. Why this ghost in particular is that reason. The blue ghost will give you a ton of money. Oh, and I completely messed up. Whatever, I'm gonna get the money. Bitch, don't my banana. Don't throw me your bananas. God. Ah, sucked. I am waiting. And... wait. Ah! Are you serious? It's always the gargantuan Donkey Kong. Okay, seriously. Let's play Curse. Don't affect me. Ah! Oh, come on! Wait, where are you? Damn it. Thank you! Yeah, try not to get dragged also while you're getting sucked in because you will lose health. That's what you get for throwing bananas at me, you douche! Oh, hell! Oh, god, another one? Damn it! And I I believe there's one more. I think it's right here. There it is. Oh, excuse me. Aw, oh, you suck. Come here. There we go. And now we just get the key. And now we have the key that goes into that room. And this, and that's like the majority of the area one. But before I do that, there is a toad over here. I'm slightly multitasking right now. I'm going on my phone and on this at the same time. So, yeah. Because I do have a social life other than the other gamers. That is another save point, by the way. And I could go down, but I can. But I'm going to find a brand new method. If you go and hit X, you'll go into this screen. And if you hit that button, you can warp from any mirror to here. It's a quite cool thing, actually. Let me see if I can... And also, what makes it really cool is... Let me see if I can actually do it. Wait. Can I trigger it now? I've triggered it a couple... There we go! Yeah. If you stand in a particular spot... and you haven't completed Area 1 yet, which is the entire upstairs area for right now, the ghost will bring the chandelier down on you. It's quite interesting, and... Phone call! Hold up a sec, it's me, Professor Iga, the spirits, and we've been yet seeing you around. You must be some of those escape gallery ghosts. I will explain this in the next episode, actually. You should know that they're really different from the other ghosts you've seen so far. They don't know each other hot very easily. If you find one, you should refer to the X button to search it hard for clues. Okay. Well, so now we can do it. This also begins to an enemy that is sometimes very annoying. Fake doors. And I'm going to quickly explain while we enter this room, before we enter the first area, what the fake doors, how you can tell them apart, really. So, I'm going to first start sucking in all the coins. So, you see these two doors here. This one. And this one. The one behind me is fake. The one in front of me is real. Here's how you can tell. If you can use your vacuum on the door and it doesn't start shaking, see, fake door, nothing. This door, shake. It's fake. Second reason, it doesn't show up on the map. I'm in front of the other door. That one, the other one behind me, not there. Also, another thing to look at, there's a little rug-like runner thing right in front of the door. This one? Excuse me! Aww, that is so douchebaggy. Death, injury by that. And you see over here? Nothing. It's a fake door. So, keep that in mind. Now, we'll go into the actual door here. First go up by... There's a book that he always tries to attack me with. You gonna try to kill him again? No? Okay, good. If you look over here, and you don't... And... See if I can get it right here. Damn it, I have to go closer. You'll see a piece of cheese. Why is there cheese? Well... You see a little ghost mouse, and if you suck him up... You get all a ton of money! And he had an emerald. I think that's an emerald. I'm using my logic from Ocarina of Time, because I've been playing that like crazy. And now we have this guy, so let's follow what he got said and see what he looks. Oh, go ahead, try to find me. I can see you, but you cannot see me. Wow, that's helpful. I'm gonna wait right here. Now the trick here is, right there, he yawns, his heart is showing, and you can suck him up. Now he'll drop these like pearls and stuff like that, and in fact, you can get a huge pearl if you bring him down to like, 10. Douchebag. Aw, oh, you suck. If you get to like level If you get to, like, 10 under in one consecutive, suck, he'll drop a gigantic one that's worth a ton. So hopefully the next time I get it, I'll be able, next, ghost we catcher, I'll get it. And we get another cube of that. Damn it! Damn it, why didn't I listen to Proton and John? Don't eat the mushroom! Oh, and apparently you can't even do anything about opening up chests, and now we have a key. Yay! That opens that room. Is there anything up here? Oh yeah, coins. Alright, and so, is there anything else here? Oh, heart. Lame. Nothing here. Well, let's go. Let's see. Ooh, there he is. Let's analyze it. Isn't my hair just gorgeous? Of course I do spend a lot of time on it. I was so bored cooped up in that painting. Now I spend all the time in front of the mirror. It seems to scare people though, so everything's coming up roses. Ooh, I have an idea. Let's mess up her hair! And we got her! She's gonna back into the wall. Come on! No! No! Don't eat the mushroom! Come on, come on! No. You douche! Oh my god, you suck! I hate you, you stupid ghost. What the frick? Let's play Curse! Screw you. And you cannot get a consecutive, and you cannot get a gigantic ass suck on the boss levels either, so... This is embarrassing how I suck so badly at this game right now. Despite the fact that I'm like 22 minutes into the video right now. I'm just gonna put it as one. Whatever! And we got that third. Ooh, cutscene! That means we are facing the boss next! Fun! I'm gonna take it on these mice in my anger. Okay, the nursery. This room is awesome to get more health. Because there's a gigantic heart there that is worth 50 harp HP, and it'll respawn every time you come back in there. Like, it will respawn when you like go to a couple of rooms, and then you come back. I think to activate this boss battle, I think it's this. Yeah, there it is. Hey, what up, Wei? No. Oh, and now he's gonna teddy bear this. Bitch, I don't want your teddy bears. To get so to fix that, go to the bottom! And I'm gonna skip through this. And now we get taken to the boss arena! Which is a gigantic ass crib. Nice pad, yo! This boss is kind of an easy one. I mean, it is the first boss, but it's really simplistic. I mean, you can get it down to a pattern. Because the first area is extremely linear and pretty easy. There's grab keys and everything like that. It's the other areas that can get a little bit tricky. So, yeah. That was weird. So the first attack you'll do is pretty much you'll send these little horses. Really easy to get away from. My best option is to see if we just get him out of there, just to get him quicker. So I kind of go near him. And then he'll throw all these little toy balls at you. One of them will bounce back on, and that's the one you want to suck up and hit him with. And then suck away. Now, it is impossible to get him in more than in one suck because there are phases of the battle. And no, you cannot do it in two phrases. And then his third attack is gigantic ass belly flop, which doesn't work because we're on the other side of the room. Derp. Attack. Attack. Send in the balls. That sounds so wrong. There is the ball. Eep! I don't know, what is that about to do? Eep! Nylon inflatable stuff. Now, when you get to this point in the battle, he will attempt to fake you when he does his belly flops, and the, there's another attack added on to his first stage. And they will be coming a lot faster as well. And then he'll set some in the middle. And you're gonna stand in the middle, and he won't pass you. It's really easy. Now let's get away from these. Hit him, and let's take him out. Yeah! Da 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 da! Yay! And now that the room is regenerated, you can get that heart. I said, we can get the heart. There we go. And we can get the area 2 key. This will unlock the door that had all the weird things on it in the bottom floor of the entrance. Can we get a call? Can you hear me? Oh, thank goodness you're okay. I lost contact with you all of a sudden. I was a tad worried. You were gonna tuck after that big long battle, didn't you? Go back to the lab. When you vacuum a boss goes, it gets pretty much full to bursting. Okay. That's who's boss. Wow! That's a great joke. One piece. Call it the Portrificationizer. Okay. Sure. And not only that, it works in reverse, too. Huh? All I do is use VS. Well, it's simple. Just plug that pole, took us 3,000 into my vessel, and enjoy the ride. Whoa, oh my god, that's so cool. Ghosts are invisible. So, if they're invisible, why is it that we're able to see the ghosts sing? Yeah, gaming logic, I don't know. And we can turn them into ghost portraits. I will explain the ghost portraits a little later in, the LP, actually in the next episode, so it should be early. It turns back to me and your help. Let's check the statistics! Area 1, we got Neville, Lydia, and the boss ghost is Chauncey, which I always failed at. So, 3 Gala ghost costs so far, 118 coins, 64 slips, 1 emerald, and a complete epic fail and everything else. So, 3,770,000 coins, or gold, or whatever it's pronounced. And the last gold recording I had exactly 6 million. Fail. And I will save. That is just totally sad. So, now that we are here, I think I'm going to cut off the video. I'm about 29 minutes in, so I'm going to stop. So, anyway, next time on Luigi's Mansion, we are going to start off Area 2. And we will get as far as we can get in about 15 minutes or so. So, anyway, Thank you for watching. If you are interested in joining Dayum.com, please do. Don't forget to like and subscribe and favorite this video for more. And I will see you guys next time.